Network's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. A good one on tap for you this afternoon between the LA Dodgers and the Seattle Mariners.
And now, your 2021.
It's Interleague Baseball on MLB
Seattle
Network.
Mariners.
Marco Gonzalez is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Mariners. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. He will lead this one off today.
Mookie Betts.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And afternoon baseball on MLB Network is underway.
First pitch, 1 o'clock.
And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. Still a bit of a chill in the air. 53 degrees our game time temperature. The 1-1.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
He's got it. And there's one down now.
Batting second, the shortstop, Corey Seager.
Now it'll be Corey Seager. First pitch of the AB now. And they start him out away with a called strike. That just misses off the inside for ball one. So let's take a peek at the officiating crew in this one. Behind the plate is Kenny Jansen.
You know, Kenny Jansen, D-Row, he's kind of hard to figure out. Doesn't give a lot on the edges. He'll make you bring the ball into that plate.
Yeah, Dan, Kenny Jansen is definitely consistent, and he'll reward pitchers around the knees. But on the edges right there, sometimes it's hit or miss.
Little chopper back to the mound. Throw on to first, two gone. So here is Justin Turner. In his career versus this pitcher, he's a 333 hitter. Now here's the first offering. Here's the 0-1 pitch.
Nope, ball one.
And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. To 2-2 now.
That's a great sinker right there. These batters are going to have to bear down because if he's got that good pitch working, it's going to be a long game. They might have to sit off speed.
Here now the 2-2. Two out, nobody on. Still 2-2. Grounded weakly toward third. Right to him. Over to first, and that retires the side. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Now it'll be the M's turn. No score. Julio Urías will be on the mound for the boys in blue. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, we're getting a look at one of the most versatile pitchers in all of baseball in Julio Urías. He's been successful in the bullpen. He's had some success as a starting pitcher. One of the top young pitchers in all of baseball.
Into the box, Mitch Haniger. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Now the 0-1. Behind 0-2 now.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
A ball and two strikes to Mitch Haniger.
Hey, textbook waste pitch right there. Does he go elevated fastball again or something slow below the zone?
The 1-2. Is swung on and missed, strike three.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
So here now is Ty France as he'll take a look at ball one. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. One out, nobody on. Fouled away.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Here comes the 1-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager, as he swings and grounds it toward the hole. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. Mariners are down in order. Still no score. Striding in is Cody Bellinger. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. Called strike 0-2.
No ball, two strikes.
Nothing and two count and the pitch. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
This is the kind of at bat where your hitting coach grabs you on the way back to the dugout to have a little chat about your approach. Not a lot of positives to draw from that at bat when you take two strikes and then you chase one out of the zone to go down on only three pitches.
Here now is Will Smith. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. And this is low, ball two, 2-1. 2-2 to the Dodgers catcher.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Line to the right side. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Well, that's what's difficult about pitching. You have a guy that's up there swinging. Pitch before this takes a big swing and almost falls down, and then he shortens it up and hits a base hit right on the next pitch.
Yeah, Dan, that's what we call the old bait and switch right there. Try to go deep, count leverage, get to two strikes, shorten up, and do your job.
And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy as he takes a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. Lifetime versus this arm. He's hitless in three at-bats. Here's the 0-1. Hit on the ground to short. And that's through for a hit.
Hey, you know what? Right there, he executed a pitch. He can't worry about where it's going. He just wants to put it on the ground right there, give his defense a chance to work, and it found a hole, period, the end.
Stepping in now, A.J. Pollock. As it's on the ground toward the hole, and a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate.
Hey, Dero, they're making this guy pay. That's three straight singles and a run driven in.
Yeah, nothing hit extremely hard. Killing them softly, station to station with those knocks.
Matt Beatty stepping in as the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. Muncy at second, Pollock at first, one gone. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. And it's 1-2.
One ball, two strikes. Yeah.
Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
At the plate, Chris Taylor. As he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. The 1-0. Swing and a miss on the sinker, a ball and a strike. Lifetime versus this pitcher. He's 1-for-3. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
1-2 is the cut fastball, but he holds back 2-2.
Now 2-2, two on, two out. This is when you have to make a pitch right here. The last thing you want to do is run the count full to 3-2. Then the runners are going to be off to the races.
Dodgers have the early 1-0 advantage as we play the second. All right, back to him on the mound. And he'll flip it on to first, and with it, that ends the inning. Only one in the inning here for the guys in blue. Bottom of the inning now, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Kyle Lewis.
The center fielder. Kyle Lewis.
Here's the first pitch as he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. Now the 1-0 is in there for strike one. The 1-1 is taken for ball two. Out in front here is this one scorched, foul to the left. The 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Batting fifth.
So bases are empty with one gone. And up next is Evan White. He's set and the pitch. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2.
Boy, so far early into this one, this guy's pitching really well. And I'm a big believer in body language. He's getting the ball. He's working really quick, keeping the ball down in the zone. And if you take a look at this guy so far early on, a lot of positive signs. He looks like he brought his good stuff in this one.
That fastball straightens him up a bit. 1-2 now. Pitch on the way. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Wow, his stuff looks electric coming out of the gates in this one, guys. That's five batters faced, four strikeouts. That's going to be a tough pace to keep up, but it looks like he has what it takes to work deep into this game.
Into the box, Dylan Moore, as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Oh, and one count and the pitch. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. In past meetings with Julio Urias, small sample, a perfect 1-for-1. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. And a great inning here as he gets another punch out and strikes out the side in order. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. It remains 1-0. Here's Mookie Betts. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And now the first pitch. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. He's set. Here's the 0-1. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. To the left side, but it's well foul. Here it comes. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now. Right side, hit hard. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
The batter, number
Here's
five.
Corey Seager. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First pitch of the AB on its way. And that misses inside 1-0. Now the pitch. High in the air down the right field line. Bases are empty, one man out. High in the air down the right field line. And this ball is popped up, drifting back behind the mound. Throw just in time as they get him by an eyelash. Next for the Dodgers, Justin Turner. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Now here's the first offering. Swing and a miss on the sinker, 0-1. And it's 1-1.
One ball, one strike.
Hard hit ball to second. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Hey, that's a nice piece of hitting by your three-hole guy right there. First two guys, not so much. Now they bring up the monster in the four-hole with two outs. They have a chance to make a nice inning out of this.
Cody Bellinger at the plate now. He gets a shot to hit here in the inning following the two-out single.
Yeah, and that hit might not amount to much, but anytime you can extend an inning and give a guy with plenty of pop a chance to swing it, the outlook of an inning changes dramatically.
First pitch on its way. And a strike called at the knees, nothing in one.
This is why pitching is so difficult. You're cruising along to give up a hit. Now you've got to lock in and get this middle part of the order done.
Oh and one, here it comes. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Tough one to call there, but it's ruled just above the zone. And that's a fair ball, lined to the right side. The relay, but he'll be in there with a double.
The good news for pitchers in this park is that it doesn't give up many home runs. A lot of room in the outfield. Sometimes that's the bad news as well, though, because there's a lot of space for hits to get down and to go for extra bases just like that.
So now to the plate, Will Smith. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. He's got a chance to add to this early lead as he'll bat with a couple of guys in scoring position. Ready with the 1-0. Swung on and missed. 1-1. Just off the end of the bat, it's a foul ball, and he'll stick around. Ready with the 1-2. Lifted down the line in left. Long run for the left fielder, and they can't run it down. Check swing in the dirt, but he went around. And a good throw is in time, and they escape the jam. Dodgers strand a couple. They lead it 1-0. So stepping in is Braden Bishop. He starts off the inning against a guy who struck out the side last inning. How did they get to him here?
I'm not sure, Matt, that they want to stay as patient. He's been throwing a lot of strikes. They might want to start swinging a little bit earlier in the count.
Now the pitch.
Oh, that's out.
In past meetings with Julio Urias, not a big sample size, 0 for 1. The 1-0 home.
Oh, that's out.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Well, knowing the threat this guy poses if he gets on base, I think the next pitch should be a challenge pitch. You don't want to give guys that can run a free chance to cause havoc out there, especially the leadoff guy.
Got to find the strike zone. Here's the 3-0.
3 balls, 1 strike.
In there, and it's full 3-2.
Hey, excellent job to get yourself back in this count after throwing three consecutive balls. You got a chance to get an out right here.
Yanked on the ground down the line. That's a hit, the first of the game for the Mariners.
Sometimes you get lucky in this game. I don't think pitch recognition wise, he would choose to swing at that exact pitch. But you know what? Sometimes result is the only thing that matters.
And that'll bring in Tom Murphy. As the first pitch here is a bit high, it's ball one. Good sharp curveball there. The count 1-1.
Hey, that's just a nice get me over curveball there to steal a strike. I don't think he was looking for that one.
Hit hard back up the middle. He'll go to the bag for one. On to first, a double play.
Batting ninth. The shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
So base is empty now after the double play. And coming forward now is the shortstop, J.P. Crawford. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Fouled off. Bases are empty here with two men out. Owen 2, the count to Crawford. Started to go around, but it's a called third strike anyway, and that will retire the side. Mariners go down quietly there. They still trail 1-0. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, thanks, Heidi. All set for the start of the inning, and digging in is the big-time power threat, Max Muncy.
Max Muncy.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Ball,
The 1-0. 1-1 the count. A ball and two strikes now.
One ball, two strikes, count.
And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed, and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
At the plate now, A.J. Pollock, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. One for one with a single so far. And now pitch on the way. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. One run, five hits, no errors for the Dodgers thus far. Grounded back up the middle, scooped up. Throw gets him, two down.
Up next to the Dodgers.
So the bases are empty with two gone now, and here's Matt Beatty to hit now. Becomes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Left side, but well foul. Two out, nobody on. Waved at and missed, and he's behind 0-2.
I know this guy has a lot of weapons on the mound, but what makes him so successful is that he's aggressive in the zone, getting ahead, forcing action.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the shot is retired. Dodgers down in order, but they're up 1-0. Back to the top of the order now, and up next, the corner outfielder Mitch Haniger.
The Mariners, the right fielder, Mitch Haniger.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Off the plate, ball one.
Ready with the 1-0 pitch, and it's fouled away. Again, another foul ball. Look out, that one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Now here it comes, and this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
Boy, this guy has really good stuff so far on this one. How about seven Ks, and we're just in the middle innings of this one. If he continues this up, this could be a real solid performance.
In now, Ty France, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ballgame. Now a pitch on the way. Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
Pretty impressive back-to-back strikeouts to start the inning. What's even more important is now he gets to face the middle of the order without anybody on base for them to drive in.
To the plate now, Kyle Seager. And he's a bit tardy there on the first pitch fastball. It's nothing and one. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Oh, and this at bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0 and 2 now.
Hey, after that terrible swing, you find yourself down 0-2. Step out, deep breath, adjust the batting gloves, flip a coin, and go all in on something.
Nothing in 2 count, and the pitch. Pretty well hit. Deep down the line in right, but that's back into the seats. Foul.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball.
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Mariners are down in order. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Stepping in once again is Chris Taylor. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
That evens it up 1-1. The pitch. Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing at that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box now, Mookie Betts. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. No hits to this point. And he falls behind 0-2. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike 3 called, and there are 2 down.
2 up, 2 down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Corey Seager.
Here's Corey Seager. And he'll promptly send it in the air out to center field. Lewis will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers, but they lead it 1-0. Welcome back to T-Mobile Park in Seattle as we send it down to Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Mariners manager Scott Service during the break about his team's offensive performance so far, and he told me, overall, he's not happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
All right, Heidi, thank you. So here's the cleanup hitter, Kyle Lewis. He leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can tell in between innings the veterans in that dugout going up and down the line, trying to keep this lineup from getting super frustrated. They just have to find a way to piece it together, maybe pass the baton, get some wheels in motion, maybe get aggressive on the base pass if they can get somebody on.
As he'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. Now a fastball as he has to lean out of the way there.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
And he fouls this one off. Now the 2-1 pitch is taken for strike two.
Wow, that's 4 straight K's. He's knocking them down. He's looking for number 5 right here. You can tell this guy on the mound, he is pitching with a whole lot of confidence in this one.
Mariners center fielder now with a full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
And he will take strike 3 call. He's got another one, 5 straight strikeouts, and that's the first out of the
number
inning.
Number 12, Evan White.
The next batter will be Evan White, as he'll take a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. Struck out in his first at bat. Come set, and the 0-1. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. No runs, just 1 hit, and no errors in the game for the Mariners to this point. That's inside and low. It's a ball and 2 strikes.
He didn't look overly fooled right there because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Here now the 2-2. Is on a line to left center, and it's going to fall, a base hit.
You take a look at the numbers up to this point. You see he's only given up 2 hits so far today, so he's been hitting his spots all game long. Remains to be seen if he can keep that shutout intact going forward, but I'm not betting against him.
Digging in now for the Mariners, Dylan Moore. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. From the belt, kicks and deals as he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. And a wild pitch here as this one's to the backstop. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, when you throw a breaking ball in the dirt, that's the danger. You have to trust your catcher, but this one skips away, and the open base takes the double opportunity away with it. Might prove to be costly.
The 1-1. Fouled away.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Runner at second here with one man out. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
He's just ringing up strikeouts left and right, but what's really impressive to me, he hasn't walked anyone either. He's just pounding the zone. His stuff is dirty today.
Stepping in now, Braden Bishop, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. The 0-1 offering. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball. Two out here and a runner at second. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Lays off the changeup, and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes.
He's got a good feel for his off-speed pitch his second time through the order, and we just saw three in a row.
Last chance for the Mariners, and that's low, ball four.
Well, he loses him there, but that's just the first walk he's given up, along with a couple of hits, so his command has been pretty solid so far.
Next to hit is Tom Murphy, trying here to plate the tying run from second. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. And here's a fastball that's nowhere near the zone. It's 2-0 now.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Ready with the 2-0. Outside, 3-0 now.
Two on, two out with a base open here as a pitcher. You have to be awful careful. You just don't want to groove something here and give this guy a pitch that he can hit one out of the park on.
He's set. The 3-0 offering.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
Three and one, here it is. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there, and a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Next to hit, J.P. Crawford trying to bring in the tying run from third here. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is.
Perfect time for a mound visit right here. Just give him a breather, a chance to collect himself and get back to work.
The 1-0. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire. Ball two. The set, and the 2-0. Two balls and a strike.
Although he doesn't use that pitch too much, if he's able to steal some strikes early in the count, could be something they have to think about.
Fouled off. Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
And it's fouled away. And he fouls this one off. Here's the payoff pitch. Fouled away. He set the payoff pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Payoff pitch on its way. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. He set the 3-2. Fouled off. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 home. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. And it's fouled away. White on third, Bishop on second, Murphy on at first with two down. This one's down to third. Throw on to first is going to be in time for the final out, and the Dodgers get a complete game shutout from their starter as this ball game is over. A single run good enough to do it today. 1-0 the final score. Los Angeles took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Julio Urías earns the victory on the mound. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon for the victorious Dodgers.